नमस्ते फ्रेंड्स, ब्रिज कोर्स स्टैंडर्ड 10th इंग्लिश डे 24 कॉम्पिटेंसी स्टेटमेंट नंबर 13 टू कॉन्वर्स इफेक्टिवली इन डिफरेंट सोशल कॉन्टेक्स्ट्स एंड रियल लाइफ सिचुएशंस लर्निंग आउटकम्स टू कॉन्वर्स इफेक्टिवली इन डिफरेंट सोशल कॉन्टेक्स्ट्स एंड रियल लाइफ सिचुएशन टू इम्प्रूव फ्लुएंसी थ्रू रेगुलर प्रैक्टिस एंड स्पीकिंग स्किल्स drills to ask and answer different questions to be able to discuss and express their opinions. Friends, now you have to be very careful for the next instructions. This is oral activity or a spoken activity, and you are at your homes. I am interacting with you from my home. So we are not physically face to face to converse or interact. So this is a big barrier. But let us try to overcome the situation somehow. So I request you to find 2 to 3 friends, either your siblings or the friends in your neighbor. Assign the roles. Just play the different roles and enjoy the conversation. While conversing with each other in the given situation, observe and ensure the gestures, eye contact of each other. This kind of practice will improve your fluency in speaking, and you will be able to speak spontaneously. Don't be afraid of the mistakes. Here, in learning activity, the printed conversation has been given on SCRT PDF page number 71. There are 3 roles. Imagine the characters. Tree is speaking to a pigeon and a sparrow. So the characters are tree, pigeon and sparrow. Consider them human beings as they are speaking. So here is personification, and play the roles and enjoy it. After completing this activity, then listen to this extension activity. This is a conversation of meaningful exchanges among 3 students on importance of listening to stories.
Hi Pranita, do you like to listen to stories?
Yes, very much. My granny made it habit for me to listen to bedtime stories since my childhood.
That's good habit, Pranita. In fact, I also read a story before going to sleep.
Great. Which stories do you prefer to read, Sumit?
I mostly read moral stories. Sometimes I read animal stories also.
Anita, why are you asking us about listening to stories today?
You both are very lucky guys. I never had listened to or read any story. But now I am realizing the importance of listening to stories.
You are absolutely right, Amita. Listening to stories makes us familiar with new vocabulary in context. And it's law of nature that first comes listening and then speaking.
I do agree with Sumit. Those who listen to more and more, they speak spontaneously and fluently.
Friends, today I promise you to read a story every night before going to bed.
Good luck.
It will be great if you give us listening practice of the stories you read.
Surely. Whenever we will be together, I will narrate you the read stories.
It will be fantastic if we do it alternately.
Promise. Bye. See you tomorrow. Practice activity. Now imagine the Sayadri talks to you, telling how it is being injured, means destroyed, by very cruel people. For example, bhu mafias, illegal mine owners, illegal constructors, owners of illegal projects, irresponsible forest officers, and some selfish citizens. It appeals you to mobilize nature lovers and make a quick action plan to save it. It is extremely restless to see the loss of lives and nature on its lap due to landslides, heavy floods. Right? Meaningful exchanges of each, the Sahyadri and you. Hello friend, what's your name?
I am Janvi.
I see you here every Sunday.
Yes, I love you. I love tree conservation. I come here every Sunday to water these plants and take their care.
You and your friends are less in number who concern about me.
In fact, we have to be grateful to you. You are our lifeline due to your dense, green, thick cover of forest. You have blessed us in many ways. You are the origin of the rivers confluencing with the Arabian Sea and the Bay of Bengal. You are the only largest biodiversity here in Maharashtra.
You are right, but very soon this will be history. Presently, the devils have encompassed me.
Oh, it's very dangerous for all the living things, including we, the human beings living in your lap. Our survival is endangered due to your destruction by wicked and selfish monsters.
I have not forgotten the Mishap of Malin, and now Taliye, Mirgao, and at many more places. I am in tears. Save me for the sake of your survival.
I promise you to make the people aware of this hazard, to bring them in action mode, to mobilize them for your protection, for your existence. I also beg your pardon for the monsters in my community who have troubled you a lot, broken your limbs. But we will be soothe you, heal you by prohibiting the minings, conserving your green layers. We will save you. You are the source of our survival.
Thank you from the bottom of my heart.
Please mention not. It's my pleasure.
Practice activity number 2. Read the following instruction and do as directed. Now imagine, you are living in the lap of the Brahmagiri mountain near Trambakeshwar. You must have read in newspaper how it is being destroyed. The Brahmagiri is talking to you. Make 5 meaningful exchanges of you and the Brahmagiri mountain. And finally, write my takeaway. So what you have learned through today's conversation activities, you have to write in your own words. Thank you.